Coach, with how this thing started to how it ended, it seems like we've talked about this before, but your team never gets rattled, and you come away with an impressive win, especially considering the way the first few minutes went.
Yeah, very impressive. I'm extremely proud of our guys. You have to give a ton of credit to UND and the staff and Tommy Schuster. The kid's a really, really good football player. You know, he's a competitor. And the way it started, you know, our guys could have lost faith, and they didn't. And we got to shore up some things on special teams, but and get healthy. But I'm really excited about the win.
Well, 14-0, UND leads it, and it has the ball. And then one of the plays of the game, Dyshawn Gales really turned everything around with that pick six.
Well, the pick six and the fact that Schuster hadn't thrown but two interceptions the whole season, if I'm correct. And we got him twice. So huge play by Dyshawn. And I don't think that energized our offense, but it did do something for our football team.
Well, and speaking of energizing the offense, the one that maybe did was Tucker Kraft. That catch he had, to have him back to make the catch, to come down the field and score that touchdown in the first half. Nice to have number 85 back in the arsenal.
Yeah, he's a really good football player, and he's worked very hard, deserving of the plays he makes. And it's good to have him back and healthy. And, you know, heck, Mark was 17 for 22. You can't play much better than that. And our guys made plays when he threw him the ball.
One of the other plays you alluded to already, late in the first half, UND is up 7 in field goal range. They take a shot deep to the end zone of Malik Lofton and give it up 6 inches to Garrett Mogg, out jumps him for the football and makes the interception in the end zone.
Yeah, huge play. You know, that because it ended the half, I don't think it felt as huge, as big as it was, but that was a huge play. No points, no momentum at the end of the first half for those guys. And really, and talk about big heart. He went up and took the ball. That was super.
All right, now you know what people are asking for the second straight week. Coach, talk about that halftime speech of yours.
I said the same thing. I said exactly the same thing. And at the end of the game, I always ask them if we can play better. And I said, can we play better at halftime? And they did. They played really well.
Your offense, what changed for that group in the second half?
You know, I think we just understood what they're doing. They do a lot of stuff on defense. And our guys were seeing it, and then, so we were able to draw it up. We did not put any new plays in that I'm aware of. And our guys just got into a sink. And we had some good field position too, right, which helped out a ton. You know, the punt return, the strip on the fumble, those types of things help you out.
Well, and that's the interesting thing too, is that you document there were some things on special teams you didn't do very well. By the same token, Jaden Yockey has the longest kick return of the season for you, and that unbelievable punt return he had as well.
Yeah, I think he ran like 200 yards to go 70. But it was a heck of a play, and would have loved to see him get in because he had a really special day on offense too. But big play by him.
Yeah, he had some tremendous catches. And Mark Gronowski's day, I mean, throwing for 3, rushing for 2, and we talk about it a lot, but his leadership means so much to this team.
It does, yeah, it does. And when he's on the field, he's a calming spirit. He makes plays. I don't think he felt like he was playing great at the start of the game, but, boy, he settled in and made some great throws. And then let's give Zach some credit on the tight end sneak for the 1 touchdown and the reverse throwback, those types of things. You got to know the right time to call that. He was on today.
And we talk about leadership. Another guy who plays such a huge role being a leader on this team is Adam Bach, and how you guys were able to bounce back from that, because you see him go down in the first series of the game, unable to return. That could be deflating to a lot of teams, and how you guys handled that went a long way to why you won today.
Well, I think two things, and you're right. He's a great player for us, and I think two things come into play. Number one, Adam didn't hang his head. He was out there cheering on his guys. And number two, our philosophy. We don't say next man up. We just say believe in your guys, which is any man up, they can do it. And we had a lot of guys doing it today.
Well, and what stood out to me is the last couple of weeks, USD, NDSU, you've won by dominating time of possession in the second half and just grinding things out and controlling the clock. Today, you only had the ball on offense for 23 minutes and 40 seconds. It was some of those big plays you talked about. You found a different way to win on the road against a top 20 team in a tough environment.
Well, again, short field, it's sometimes big plays, sometimes throwing the ball. And, you know, Mark pointed out, you know, it's kind of unusual, Coach. We had more points than we had plays. And I said, that's what counts, the points.
How proud are you of this group right now?
I'm really proud of them. You know, there's some pressure when you become number one, and we've never been there before. And so I think that was part of it too. And I think we'll settle in and say that was okay. It was okay to play the way we played, and we're going to need to correct some things. And I feel bad for Drotz at the end there with the punt team, but we got to block. I mean, it was like nobody was blocking, and disappointing that they got the touchdown, but very proud of my guys, our guys.
All right, the usuals. What are you happiest with from today?
Finding a way to make a win and handle the adversity. The crowd was intense. We quieted those guys down in the second half. So just really the maturity of our football team.
Biggest disappointment today?
The injuries. Yeah, we had a lot of guys that ended up leaving the field, not coming back. And then the 2 15-yard penalties when you got a chance, I think it was after a fourth down, you got a chance to go in and score. That's not a mature football team at that point. We have a mature football team, but that was not mature at the time.
How excited are you to play a home game next Saturday?
I'm just excited to be the head football coach at South Dakota State, Tyler. Hobo Day, Hobo Week. I love tradition. I love our part of that week. I love our stadium. I hope our fans turn out and support the Jacks.
They certainly have to this point this season.
They have. Like, I literally cannot ask for a better support from the in-person people, and I know the people watching and listening.
Coach, congratulations. Appreciate the time.
Thanks, Tyler. Take care.